This screencast demonstrates how to solve for a maximum temperature when you have uniform generation. So here's our plane wall. As you can see, it has a Q dot, which is our generation, our maximum temperature, which is right here. This indicates that the wall is insulated on one side, and on the other side, we have some surface temperature. The wall is subjected to convection on this side. So we start with the simplified form of the heat equation. So we have d squared T dx squared, but now we have to include our generation term, Q dot, divided by K, which equals zero. Or we can just write it that d squared T dx squared equals minus Q dot over K. And let's integrate this twice. So first we have dt dx equals minus Q dot over K times X plus our first constant. And we integrate it again to get our temperature distribution, which is minus Q dot over 2K times X squared plus C1X plus C2. So we're going to need two boundary conditions to figure out our two constants. So at x equals zero, dt dx equals zero because it's insulated, so there's no temperature gradient. Therefore, we say minus Q dot over K times x plus C1 equals zero. So if x equals zero, therefore C1 has to equal zero. So next we say at x equals L, where L is the length of this wall, our temperature equals some constant surface temperature. So now TS equals minus Q dot L squared over 2K plus our second constant. And this allows us to solve for our C2. And all we did here was substitute TS for our temperature and L for our X. So now we're left with this temperature distribution for our plane wall insulated on one side and subjected to convection on the other side. So we're looking for T max, and dT dx equals zero at x equals zero. The maximum temperature is at x equals zero. So if we put in x equals zero into our distribution, our temperature distribution, we find that this T max equals Q dot L squared divided by 2K plus T sub S. And this can be used for any system that can be considered adiabatic. For example, if you have a wall where here's the midplane and you have this symmetric, that's not quite symmetric, but I hope you know what I mean. You have this symmetric temperature distribution. Here's our zero, here's our L, here's our minus L. At x equals zero, there is no temperature gradient, dT dx equals zero. So we can use the same temperature profile that we found earlier. The question is now, how do we find that T sub S? And now we use the fact that we have convection. So we know at x equals L, let's go back and take a look here, conduction equals convection. Therefore, minus K dT dx equals H TS minus T infinity. So now we find what minus K dT dx equals at x equals L. And when we take our derivative with respect to x, put in L and simplify, we find that minus k dt dx equals q dot times L. And this is going to equal h ts minus t infinity. Therefore, if we want to find the surface temperature, it is q dot times L divided by h plus t infinity.